Hi everyone, let's start a new adventure where we will learn to solve questions from famous Olympiad all over the world like UKMT Maths Challenge, Maths Kangaroo, SASMO, CIMO and International Maths Olympiad etc. So we have taken some question from UKMT 2020 Pink Kangaroo. Let's try to solve this question. So first question say, the diagram shows a shape made from 10 squares of side length 1 cm, joined edge to edge. What is the length of the perimeter? So if I talk of perimeter, what does it mean? So perimeter simply means only the sum of the outside boundary. So what is the boundary here? If you see, this is the boundary, right? This is the full boundary. So this is 1 centimeter, this is 1, 1, 1, 1, and this again 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. So we'll like to just put it like that and we'll just count it, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. So how much we got? 18. So just our answers come 18. Okay, so I'll repeat. So when you go for perimeter, so we are just going to form only the outside boundary, right? Let's go to question number 2. So here you can see, they speak about in each of the cells, a number is to be written so that the sum of the 4 numbers in each row. So when we are talking about rows, each row and each column, each row and each column will have a specific sum. But you don't know the sum. The sum is not given, right? It is a magic square type of thing, but they have not given the sum. The sum is not disclosed. So let's put a Y here and we'll try to crack the question. So you see 8 plus 4, 12 and 15. So sum could be what? 15 plus Y, right? So my sum is 15 plus Y. So I'm going to solve the question so that everywhere the sum will be 15 plus Y. So if you go and check here, what is the sum for this row? 7, 6, 13, 14, 7, 6, 13, 15. So only a Y will do. Similarly, if you check these ones this way horizontally, so 6, 3, 9, 9 plus 1, 10. So 5 plus Y will do our job. And if I go like this vertically, so 7, 5, 12, 13, 14. Only one. So now you see we are very close to the answer. And this way we have to find this side. So it will be just 7. Because 7, 7, 14 plus 1, 15 plus Y. So you can see just that way we can click very fast our answer. That answer must be 7, right? So the question looks little bit tough, but it was very, very easy. Now you see this question. So in the calculation zone, each letter stands for a digit, right? And they're used to make some two-digit numbers. So some two-digit numbers are given and the two number on the left have a total of 79. So sum is given as 79. So here you can see K and M one time and K and F another time. So 9 and 9 will be repeated. So 8, that means my unit digit will have 8. So this rejected and this rejected. Only these and these could be our answer. So I have to crack what the other numbers possibilities are there. So now if you see J and L, so J and L here, J and L here. What is the value of J and L? See, 7. So if you put 7 here, so if I'm going to put 7 here and 7 here, so just we can find our answer. 9 plus 9, 18, carried over 1. 7, 7, 14 plus 1, 15. So our answer will come straightforward 158. Right. So this how we can solve this Scripta algorithm questions. So let's go to the next question. I will suggest when you are solving the questions, just pause the videos and just try to do it yourself and just see what method you have used to try to do it, and then you can just compare with the solution we are doing, right? So let's do this question. So the positive integers a, b, c, d satisfy the equation a, b equal to 2cd, right? It is given a, b equal to 2cd. And now they are asking which of the following numbers could not be the value of the product, could not be. Okay, it is a negative question. So just be careful while reading the question. So what will be the value of the product a, b, c, d? So let's multiply a, b, c, d. So this is my product. I multiplied by c, d on the left hand side. So my right hand also will be multiplied and I got a perfect number. So a, b, c, d divided by 2 is a perfect number. Perfect square number, I should say. It should be a perfect square number. So let's see which is a perfect square number on dividing by 2. Here it is 25. Here it is 50. Here it is 100. Here it is 225. And here it is 400. Now you can see only 50 is not a perfect square number. So this will be our answer, right? So just you see, some very small concepts Olympiads are using, and by just using little of our imaginations and brain, we can solve the question very nicely. Okay, let's go to next question and the last question for today's evening. So let's see, Mary had 10 pieces of paper. So she has 10 pieces of paper. Either she has a square paper or she has triangular paper as seen here, right? And the rest were triangles. So there are two shapes. And now she cut 3 squares diagonally from corner to square. So how many squares are being cut? 3 squares are cut. You don't know how many squares are there and how many triangles. But out of the total squares she is having in the shape of paper, she is cutting 3 squares. And then she found that a number of squares of the vertices of 13 pieces of paper is 42. This is very important. So just you see, when you cut the square diagonally, so what is happening to the vertices? So you can see my vertices are increasing. See how many vertices this has? 3, 4, 5, 6. So now new figure has 6 vertices and this one is having 4 vertices. So what is the net change after cutting? 6 minus 4, that is 2. And how many in each square, how much will be the change? 2. And how many squares are cut? See, 3 squares are cut. So total change is how much? Total change will be how much? 3 into 2, that is 6. So can we say it like my initial number of vertices will be 36? Because 42 minus 6, that will be my initial vertices, right? So I am just giving you hint in this question and you have to solve this question, right? So I'll just give one equation and you try to solve this question yourself, and we'll meet in the next video to solve this question. So what can be my equation? 4 square, because square has 4 vertices. You don't know how many squares. And then triangle has 3 vertices, so 3 triangle equal to 36. So I have given you little hint for this question. You try to crack it. Maybe you can use some your another method by your thinking process and you can try to solve this question. Your comments are welcome. If you like my session, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you everyone. Take care. Have a good day.